Japan, home of the rising sun and considered to be the video game capital of the world. However, most Western gamers when first picking up a Japanese game would be left saying something in the lines of, well...
58 seconds in and I still don't know what the fuck's going on. Why do these people keep flashing? What are all these words? These things are not common to a Western gamer. Button press, I have no idea what I'm doing. Why is her head inflating?
Aside from the simple fact that if you don't speak Japanese, a lot of these games are virtually unplayable for most Western gamers, and concepts and other things that may be foreign to Western gamers as well, there is one other problem I've run into when it comes to Japanese gaming, or import gaming as it's sometimes called. Not all these games are that fantastic. And I'm pretty sure any Evangelion fans who never played this game before or don't know about it just pretty much creamed their pants. Never released in the United States, and I'll tell you what, I'm kind of glad some of these games never were released in the United States, because if it had been released in the United States, there's one game it would be consistently compared to or even called a ripoff of. And you know what game that is, surprisingly enough? Smash Brothers. You take a series like Eva, and you make a game like Smash Brothers. Not even a game, a complete and utter fucking ripoff, and a shitty fucking ripoff at that. No inspiration, no ingenuity, just a complete cookie-cutter clone of the same fucking thing we already played 10 times better on Nintendo's ancient fucking console. This is amazing, no less, when you have such a high-powered opening like this and then you jump into, well, tell me what the fuck this is real fast. Okay, so up to 4 people can play. What does that remind me of? You could either have 4 regular people playing, or 4 CPU opponents playing. Set your match time options, and you know, blah blah fucking blah. Do you even understand half the stuff on screen? I certainly fucking don't, but it's functional enough to get through it. And then you pick your characters. Yeah, this doesn't remind you of anything, does it? Reminds me of something. Smash Brothers! When I'm paying X amount of dollars to import games, I want to see some goddamn originality. Not this! But yeah, it's a Smash Brothers ripoff, through and through. Well, it kind of is. You know, Smash Bros. Offers you a lot more from get-go. This thing offers you 4 levels to play on, grand total of which you have to unlock, what, 5 more? That, and there's one other thing I've got to complain about before we even get into the game. Obscenely long load times. For what? Wait till you fucking see what this thing produces for this load time. Just wait for it. You will laugh your ass off. Even Eva fans are not pleased by this shit. Wow. That was really worth that insane load time, right? The N64 did it faster! And I'm telling you right now, these graphics are not that good! However, the real problem, the main problem I have with this game, it's not even the fact that it's a cheap Smash Bros. Ripoff that looks like shit on a PS2. It's the fact that it controls like fucking shit! Seriously, I have a better time plugging my fucking DualShock into a goddamn toaster and trying to play that than play this broken sack of shit. And that, it's a clusterfuck. I mean, all you do is swing the same 2 to 3 attacks over and over and over again, and unlike Smash Bros. With its ingenuity in terms of level design and item selection, this doesn't offer jack shit. You'd be lucky you even could pick up any items, period, with these broken fucking controls! What's funny is the controls are just as basic as any other game out there, including Smash Bros., in terms of, like, your basic 4-player fighting beat 'em up. But unlike Power Stone or Smash Bros., or any game in this genre, they picked the most broken configuration of controls and setup I've ever seen, and when weapons appear on screen, getting to them is almost fucking impossible, because by the time this clusterfuck that is your enemy AI just gangbanging your ass 6 ways to Sunday is over, you're dead. I have barely won a single fucking match, even with human players playing. It is impossible! So it's not fun, it looks like shit, it plays like shit, and honestly, aside from the sound and music at points, this game is a piece of fucking shit! A waste of your time and your energy, and you know what? Truth be told, importing this game would be the same as letting the angels run free in your house. It's a moron's fucking choice! Avoid it, and leave it to the dogs! Because this game fucking sucks!
What the fuck? What am I supposed to do? Help? Oh, I see. No, wait. Hold on. Hey! What is-